everybody, and welcome back to the Damn Music Show. My name is Michael Wagner. This is Darren Drewitz. Guys, join the Damn Nation. Yes. Smash that subscribe. Ring that notification bell below. We drop a lot of videos. We educate you, and we're also here to just make fun of, as many of you do. So by all means, join it. It's a great time for all of us to be had. Darren, we're going to be listening today to who?
Parker McCollum, a guy I've known of for a while, because he's been around for a while. However, it seems like in the last 6 months... I keep running into this dude every time I flip on
he's blown up.
An award show.
It's official.
Yeah, but it seems like it's been a slow breaking wave with this guy.
I do. I think so. I don't know, actually.
I don't know.
I get requested.
Which
to
it doesn't matter.
Yeah, short story. Short story. I actually was playing at a venue. There was just a few people there. It was a private event. And I noticed none other than Mr. Parker sitting in the corner. So I was at the event playing a number of like country tunes, folky stuff. So, you know, I'm not going to play Parker a song while he's sitting right there. One.
Play Parker to Parker.
Yeah, it's like
you should have asked for a duet.
It's a little intimidating, but also it just seems intrusive. But I played a bunch of country music. So as Parker was leaving, I played a Parker McCullough song, which only seemed correct. And he turned around and he gave me a... fuck yeah, dude. And then he fist bumped it. I said, hey, good luck tonight. He was playing in Austin. He was having a good time. He said, hey, man, loved it. Enjoyed it. We'll catch you later.
Oh,
and
cool.
So I played to him as he paled away and had a good night. Anyways, Parker, let's see what you're up
rubbing
to.
Rubbing elbows on with stars.
One. Bumping
this
elbows,
is called
baby.
Stoned, is
here
my guess.
Here we go. Stoned by Parker McCollum.
When it's raining.
Oh, jumped right in.
I cry when it's dark.
Little delay action.
I feel like the whole world won't ever understand.
He's a big dude. He's like 6'3". I was like, oh, he's a good-looking guy.
That's the hardest part.
Love the B3.
Being alone, that's why I stay.
Love that
stone.
Organ. That's beautiful. That's why I stay stone.
Hey, pretty thing, can I lay my weary head on your shoulder?
I like it.
And hold you like
it a lot.
Baby, since you left this bed, just keeps getting colder. I lay here and wonder if you wonder how I'm spending my time. I cry when it's raining. I cry when it's dark. I feel like the whole world won't ever understand my heart.
So that was clearly a lyrics video, not a video, which
sure.
Is
we just listened to the song,
fine.
And we reacted to the actual song, which is great. Can I react like you and you react like me?
We
do the old switcheroo?
I feel like I might get this one wrong,
uh-huh.
But
can we do the old switcheroo?
Yeah, no, all right, you go ahead. You pretend like you mean.
Okay, I mean, I love this. This is just everything I love in country music. I had a solo, gets right to the big hook in the chorus. It has a great build to it, really has a great build to it, and then it really rocks. I'm very impressed. I really like this song by Parker McCollum. This is me doing Darren.
Darren. You got it right.
Nailed
it. Surprise.
Nailed it.
You oversimplified me.
I just giving up depth of character.
Here's what I would say. Is this song in 3/4 time?
No, 3/4. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Well, the drum beat is very traditional.
Oh, yeah. A lot of it.
And the guitar strumming, you know, they're plucked.
Those big diamonds.
Well, they're plucked strum.
They had the skanky, which is cool, but yes. They had those big diamonds. So it was like that on the one, they'd rip the cord and they just sit on it. And then they have 1, 3, 4.
That's
one,
what I'm talking
two.
That's
with
why
the skank on the side, which I really liked, which is like a Stapleton
Me
does
too.
A lot of that,
Me too.
Which I love. And that B3 I thought sounded awesome. That organ sounded fantastic.
So the way he sings the song, you know, he holds the note on the word alone instead of stone. He gets the stone. So the singing to the payoff, writing to the payoff, usually that last word is the one they stretch out. But I love the fact that he chose to do alone.
Yeah, it's fun.
Which is why I'm always stoned.
That's like, alone.
Yeah.
That's why I stay stoned. That was good.
Yeah, that's a little different to today's music, which I think gives him a chance to highlight his voice, which I think is important.
This feels like a fan's song.
A what?
A fan's song. Like, it's really good. I don't know. It's not being one of his number one hits, but it seems like if you're a fan of Parker, you're in love with this song.
Oh, yeah. I love the drum treatment and the guitar treatment, and I do like this song. And, you know, there was no one there was, and congrats to him about singing about being stoned, which is much better than jumping in the car and drinking the whiskey and dropping the hammer down.
There were some
so
lyrics in here that I really related to, I felt like I related to him as a person. Sounds like he likes his space and likes a little downtime.
There was an odd drum fill 3/4 of the way through that threw me out of the song.
The solo too is a little organic.
The solo was long for today's world. But I give this song a solid 8-. I liked it. He's got a better than average voice. And yes, I do. This is what I love about country music. And I wish there was more of it. This feels like an old traditional.
It feels a little Texas. You know, it's got a little Texas in there.
Well, he's from Texas.
I know. He kept it, though. He didn't, like, lose it. And, like, a lot of times these guys go through that red dirt sound and then they kind of bail out of it. And this feels very, very from Texas. But, like, clean like Nashville, which I liked.
It is clean like Nashville. It's more Nashville than Texas.
It still felt a little
gritty.
I
get your point.
It is more Nashville than Texas, but he didn't lose me. I was like, oh, that's still got dirt in it. That's still got like.
I think that's very fair.
They didn't overproduce it. They didn't layer a million vocals.
And it can be done, Nashville. Did you hear what he just said? He's a music producer.
I love Nashville as much as
I love Austin. You guys wrote a formulaic song. You wrote to the payoff. You allowed his voice to come through. And it was not overproduced. I agree.
I want to be clear here. I love some overproduced stuff out of Nashville. I'm a huge Nashville fan. I think some of the best players in the world are out of Nashville. I don't love
discussion.
I don't love when it loses its heart, is what I don't love. He didn't seem to lose it here. Like, we watched another video with another artist that was a country artist, and it was like, wah. Oh, no, thank you. Anyways. Right.
Well done, Parker. And we're 3 for 3 today. We liked all 3 songs.
Parker, you come across the damn show. Just remember, high five. Next time we see each other at that venue, it was a good time.
Join the damn nation, Parker.
Join the damn nation. Smash that subscribe. Ring that notification bell. I like what you're doing, Parker. Congratulations. Keep it up. Until next time.